Actually, to correct you, he's a two-time champion now. The uncrowned champion has finally got his title back.
Right, thank you. Damn concussion. I get three times for some reason. We have a gauntlet match coming up, but what words can describe what just happened here? This was certainly this generation's Hogan and Andre, but now we're moving on to the first match of the five-man gauntlet coming up. Stone Cold Steve Austin taking on CM Punk. Stipulation still in effect with Austin losing. He must pledge allegiance to the Straight Edge Society. I mean, after what we just saw, how in the hell are we going to move on from this?
I mean, this is a huge match, so much is on the line. But this is also part of, again, that five-man gauntlet match. The WEDF Championship will be on the line. The last man to win that last match is going to be crowned the WEDF Champion.
Right, and after Austin and Punk get done, they still got Morrison, Booker, and Rock to go through.
Each man, in his own right, has earned his opportunity to be here. You have the King of the Ring, you have the current champion, you have the former champion, and then you have the
Money in the Bank winner too.
That's right. You have the you have another former champion, and you have a man who's still been in pursuit after being screwed out of the WEDF Championship.
And remember, but here comes the Texas Rattlesnake right here. Whoever wins this gauntlet, I gotta give them a lot of credit. They went through all the hell. That proves that they are the best of the best.
I mean, imagine if... I would think that being one of the first two people, maybe being either Austin or Rock, whoever wins this is gonna be probably a disadvantage.
What is going through Stone Cold's mind? He's been attacked earlier on. Is he at a disadvantage?
I don't know. It's kind of hard to say. He knows who he's dealing with right off the bat. But if he beats Punk, he does not know who he's dealing with. He doesn't know if Morrison will come out. He doesn't know if the King of the Ring, King Booker, will come out. He doesn't know if the WEDF champion and his greatest rival, The Rock, will come out. It's all a toss-up after Stone Cold faces CM Punk if he wins.
I believe that Austin, there's no such thing as a disadvantage for Austin. I mean, he's proved so much in his career that he's pretty much proved that he can take anything and prevail.
One thing Austin would not want to do is join the Straight Society and give up what he lives for.
He gonna give that some bitch can whoop ass. What? What?
Mealy mouth bastard.
Now see, Austin sounds more like Austin now.
But he could lose it all if he loses this match.
Yes. This is the Austin I have wanted to see.
Now, I gotta say, I've been back in Austin this whole time. I actually planned it out that when Austin does become the WEDF champion, when he wins it all, me and him are gonna go nuts. We got a whole case of beer, and then we got cases of beer in the back. You know, we got women, we got everything planned.
But oh,
I'm gonna have a Steve Weiser in honor of his win.
Just be careful, though. This man coming out right here could ruin all of your plans. Although the plan does still sound good, just party and bullshit. But still, this man right here is out to ruin that plan, get his revenge on Stone Cold, and teach him a lesson. The Straight Edge Messiah, the Second City Saint, the former WEDF champion, CM Punk.
And CM Punk would love nothing more to enslave Stone Cold under the Straight Edge power.
You know, I would love to back CM Punk in this whole thing, but there's a few reasons why I have been able to do that, and one of them is standing outside of the ring. The fact that Punk has not been able to do this on his own, to me, proves weakness.
and yeah.
And here we go, though. But remember, Austin is a little weak. He got smashed face first through a car window by the same reason that Homer was talking about right before that hellacious world title match we previously saw.
Seems like Ezekiel Jackson is the main right-hand man to
the main insurance policy.
Oh, he has Dolph and Gallows. It seems to favor Zeke more.
I mean, when you look at the three men, you know, Ezekiel Jackson really is the most impressive out of the three.
I mean, you saw him handle Rock and Sock on the Nitro special.
Oh my God! Yeah, you saw that raw power that Zeke Jackson has got in him, and Punk countering Austin there with a suplex going to the outside. I think I know what Punk's going for here. Austin. Oh, he caught him in midair.
See, he took too long to set that up.
Punk.
CM Punk would. What do you think is going through CM Punk's mind here? Knowing he has a chance at the WEDF Championship and a chance to enslave Stone Cold at the same time. Wait.
For to go to sleep.
I think right now Punk's only thinking about winning this match. Punk only has one goal right now, and that's to destroy everything that Stone Cold stands for, and that's to force him into the Straight Edge Society.
I'm going to put it simple for both men. Grudge match first, WEDF title later.
That's right. And if you're not thinking in the moment, then that's where your game is going to be messed up.
Missed with that clothesline. Austin got out of the way of it in time.
He's jumped right over him. Wait, what is he doing here?
Oh, going for a powerbomb. Punk counters with that DDT. Oh, come on, Punk. This is the third time you've tried this. You're not going to hit it.
Rest.
Oh, wait. Never mind. Oh, I take that back. He go. Hit it.
He's going to go for the cover on that.
One.
Two.
Let's see him,
now
Punk.
Trying for the GTS, but Austin with another counter inverted DDT.
It wasn't even close. Austin immediately was able to get to fight out of it. And there's that vintage elbow to the face.
Two of this match almost never took place, and but Estrada changed it. Punk said he wanted in. Estrada says he beat Rock and Sock. Oh well, Rock with a partner of his choosing. The cover that Punk would get in, but Stone Cold did not. He took exception to that. He wanted that match with.
Did exactly what you have to do in this business, and he forced himself in. You know, sometimes you're not always going to get the approval of the person in charge, so quite frankly,
roundhouse kick Punk there. One, two.
But as I was saying, quite frankly, you just have to force yourself into a situation, and that's how Austin is able to get in this match. You know, who's going to say no to Austin?
He's done that so many times before.
But, you know, of course. Estrada. Wait, hold on. Punk. Oh. Welcome to Chicago, motherfucker, indeed. Signature backbreaker there from CM Punk.
And the kick, and Stone Cold could be out. Remember, he has a head injury. Punk seems to be going after the head at some points.
Might be best to say that, really, for Punk, either way, whether it be the go-to-sleep or the Anacon device, either one is just as dangerous and deadly.
Fighting on the apron. Goes up high risk.
Crossbody from Punk off the top rope, going for a cover. This one, two, no.
Kick out in two. Straight edge, Messiah.
But again, these right now.
Wait a minute. Punk again went for the GTS, but Austin still countering out of it.
I gotta say, right now, both of these men are taking a lot of punishment. It's gonna affect whether or not they win this match. It's gonna affect their performance down the road, because they do still have to defeat three other men if they want to become the WEDF champion.
For one, two.
Looks like Punk's showing signs of desperation in this match. He's trying to go for that GTS, but just can't seem to hit it.
Oh, but he's Luthes press.
Signature Luthes press, classic Stone Cold Steve Austin running the ropes. More classic Stone Cold with that double elbow drop.
Oh, Stone Cold.
Oh, Austin, Stone Cold Stunner.
That's got to be it.
It's going to move on. Here's the cover.
One, two, three.
Wait a minute. Ezekiel Jackson.
What the hell? God damn it. Dre, what are you doing?
Helping his Massa win the match.
Oh, fuck you.
I'm sorry, I had to do that.
You owe me 50 bucks.
I will pay your reparations. I will give you 50 bucks.
Take advantage.
Wait a minute.
GTS!
And Austin could very well be asleep.
I mean, Austin had the win, and Ezekiel Jackson gets involved, and because of that...
Oh, no!
Oh, wow.
This match is no fighting. So Zeke could have a ride to me at ringside.
F-bomb!
God damn it, ref. Oh, shit.
But you see, though... Oh, wait, never mind. I was about to say... Wait a minute, Punk! More ref bombs!
Oh, god damn it.
And Stone Cold...
No!
No, he...
CM Punk! Got him up! GTS again! Trying to put Austin to sleep. Cover. One, two.
Right.
Oh, oh, my
God. Oh, wow. Another kick out by...
And a third ref bump.
I see the ref just goes for the pin and gets the win and moves on.
The ref wins the match.
The ref is the winner. Now the ref will face Ezekiel Jackson for the WEDG championship.
Oh, again. Go for the one.
Wait, oh! DDT counter by Austin.
How much does Austin have left?
Not enough for that stunner.
Again, GTS!
But no! Counter immediately.
Another one of those DDT counters that. Oh, CM Punk! Low-balling, playing dirty.
Low-balling. It's going to give him the opportunity for another GTS.
Third GTS. Let's see if Austin can get out of this one. I don't think he will. Charm. One, two. Oh!
What?
The Texas Rattlesnake is still in this. Wait a minute. What? What is Punk doing?
Oh! I don't know. Remember, this is no disqualification.
Oh, that's right. Wait, then why were there ref bumps?
Wait, what the fuck?
Oh!
Just throws a chair at him.
Now, Punk! Oh!
Signature Punk, Shining Wizard Bulldog combination. Going for the cover.
And Stone Cold is he's gonna kick out.
Three, no!
Stone Cold lives. His cool. I mean, Stone Cold.
And he just punched him in gas to get him off the ropes. Did anybody else notice that?
This matchup. What do you think it does for his career? Do you think-